Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Ryan from Ann Arbor, Michigan asks,
I think I am a Christian. How do I know for sure?
Ryan, that is a very common question and an important one. And the fact that you're asking that question clues me in that you might be. Not necessarily that you are, but that you might be, because you in that question are expressing that this matters. Non-Christians, they don't care if they're Christians or not, of course. This is a question that only either a Christian or somebody that God is drawing to himself would ask. So how do we know if we're a Christian or not? Well, it's not marked on a time that you may have gone forward at camp or at church or something like that and prayed a prayer. That could be part of how you became a Christian, but that does not determine if you are a Christian or not. Really, I think the best way to understand if you're a Christian is to see, is your life being changed? Now, that means internally and externally. I know for me, God continues to work in my heart, and I love him more deeply. I love him in ways that I never did before, and I love him more and more as time goes on. And that expresses itself internally, what I feel about him, but also externally. That drives me to want to read the Bible more. It drives me to want to pray more, to gather and worship more. So those behaviors clue me in as well. Also, there's this idea of the fruit of the Spirit, that when you become a Christian, God adopts you into his family, he gives you the Holy Spirit, and the Spirit works on our hearts and changes us. And we develop these attributes, these fruit of the Spirit, that really manifest itself in our lives. And so love, peace, goodness, kindness, and so forth. So are you kinder today than you were before? Are you more faithful? Are you more patient? Now again, those and alone, they do not determine whether you are a Christian or not. A non-believer can be kind. But as you start looking at all this together, are you loving God more? Are you wanting to spend time with him more? Are you demonstrating these fruit of the Spirit more? Those all are great clues to the fact that you are saved. There's one final way. The Bible says that the Spirit bears witness to our spirit that we're in Christ. And what that means is this, that the Holy Spirit just communicates to us and we just know. I know it's kind of vague and kind of hard to understand, but the reality is that those who are in Christ, those who have trusted in Christ, just know that they are. This inner sense of peace and assurance. And we can't discount that. Now again, we can't lean all on that, but that's another part. So I would suggest this, that you just look at all these together. Don't focus on just one of them, but when you look at them all together, is God changing your heart? Is he changing your life? And is there a sense of knowing that you're saved? If you're seeing those things happen, then you rest knowing that you are saved. And if you're saved, nothing can change that. We know that once you're saved, you are firm in that salvation. You're safe in that salvation forevermore. So here's a question back for you. What ways have you noticed that God changes sinners who trust in him?